Imagine you are given a box and you can't see what's inside. All you know is that it is either empty or it contains a highly sensitive bomb. If this bomb is hit by even a single photon, then it will explode. Your challenge is to work out whether or not there is a bomb in the box without the bomb exploding. Classically, this is impossible. As soon as you try and detect the bomb will interact with your detector and explode. But in 1993, quantum physicists Avshalom Elitzur and Lev Vaidman proposed a quantum bomb tester, which allows us to see a bomb without looking. Hi, I'm Maria, and I am a PhD student doing research into the foundations of quantum information at the University of Oxford. Back when I was in high school, I first discovered that playing around with imaginary scenarios like the bomb tester can lead to new discoveries in physics. Since then, I wrote an article about thought experiments for a physics magazine. I wrote a poem about two characters stuck in a thought experiment for a competition. And then I did an undergraduate research project about a thought experiment involving a quantum demon. It turns out that quantum physics is full of these counterintuitive and seemingly paradoxical thought experiments, which inspired my PhD research into quantum information. I often find it easier to understand quantum thought experiments by presenting them as a quantum circuit, which I can then code on a quantum computer. So to understand the quantum bomb tester, I created a game of quantum Minesweeper. This is inspired by the classic video game Minesweeper, where the player must use clues to work out whether or not there is a bomb hidden in a box without exploding it. In my game, the clue is given by the result of measuring a qubit, which tells us whether or not to predict that the bomb is there or not. To make a bomb tester, we use a photon source to fire a single photon at a beam splitter. The beam splitter splits the photon into a superposition of being reflected and transmitted. Then we use mirrors to reflect these two photon beams together again at a second beam splitter. Here, the photon beams interfere so that they merge again into a single transmitted beam. Now, what happens if we put a bomb in the bottom path? Then, when the photon reaches the bomb will measure which path the photon is in, which will collapse the photon's superposition into either the top path or the bottom path. If the photon collapses into the bottom path, then the bomb will explode. But if the photon collapses into the top path, then it will carry on and then reach the second beam splitter. There it will split into a superposition of being reflected and transmitted. So if we detect that the photon is reflected after the second beam splitter, we know for sure that the bomb was there without having set it off. Now this proposal has only a 25% chance of letting us detect the bomb without it exploding. But later proposals showed that we can actually detect the bomb with up to 100% probability. So we can work out whether or not a bomb is there without anything interacting with it. This sounds like a paradox. The quantum bomb tester has been experimentally tested and even has applications in quantum technology. We can image delicate objects like cells by using photons that don't interact with them to cause damage. We can perform counterfactual quantum computing, where we get the result of a quantum computation by collapsing into a state where the algorithm didn't run. And we can do counterfactual quantum communication, where one person can send information to another without sending an actual particle, making it impossible for an eavesdropper to intercept the message. The quantum bomb tester and its applications are so counterintuitive, their full interpretation is still under debate. In their original proposal, Elitzur-Vaidman even suggested that the many worlds interpretation of quantum mechanics is needed to explain the thought experiment. I'm now going to show you how we can present this controversial bomb tester as a simple quantum circuit, which you can then experiment with yourself using Qiskit. So let's get started. Let's start by making a quantum circuit with two qubits. One is our photon qubit and the other is the bomb qubit. Then we use a Hadamard gate on the photon qubit to represent our beam splitter, because the Hadamard puts a photon qubit from a zero state into a superposition of 0 and 1. Next, we represent our bomb by a controlled NOT gate between the photon qubit and the bomb qubit. So if the photon qubit is a 0, then the bomb stays as an unexploded 0. But if the photon qubit is a 1, then the bomb is flipped to a 1, which means it has exploded. Next, we apply another Hadamard gate to the photon qubit for our second beam splitter. And after we measure everything, we can see what our circuit looks like. So here is what the circuit looks like. We have a Hadamard gate for our beam splitter, a CNOT gate for the bomb, and then another Hadamard gate. And then we measure our photon and bomb qubits to see what the outcomes are. So now we can run our circuit on the simulator, and then we see that we have 4 possible outcomes, each with 25% probability. The one we want is the one where the photon qubit is a 1, which shows us that the bomb, the CNOT gate, is definitely there, but the bomb qubit has stayed as an unexploded 0. We can make our bomb tester up to 100% effective using something called the quantum Zeno effect. The way this works is we make our beam splitter be very reflective, so that when the photon reaches the bomb, it's very likely to collapse into the reflected path where there's no bomb. Then we send our photon through the beam splitter again and again lots of times, and it's likely to collapse into the reflected path every time. Now, if there is no bomb there, then what happens is the photon interferes with itself as it keeps getting passed through the beam splitter, and its state gradually changes until it is fully transmitted through the beam splitter. So, by detecting whether at the end of these cycles the photon is transmitted or reflected, we know for sure whether or not there is a bomb, with a very low probability of exploding the bomb. So here is our code for the better bomb tester using the quantum Zeno effect. I won't go into detail about how this code works right now, but all of this will be in a Jupyter notebook linked in the description. We can see what this quantum circuit looks like. You can see that each of the beam splitters is an X rotation gate, and I've used lots of beam splitters and CNOT gates to simulate the photon passing through the beam splitter lots of times. Then I measure each of my bomb qubits so that I can check whether or not the bomb has exploded each time the photon passes through. So when we run this quantum circuit on the simulator, we can see from the histogram that the most likely outcome is the one where our photon qubit is 0, meaning that it tells us that the bomb is there. All the bomb qubit measurements are 0, so the bomb hasn't exploded. So when we use 6 beam splitters, we have a 2/3 chance of working out whether the bomb is there without it exploding. Now I'm going to use this bomb tester with 6 beam splitters as the basis for my game of quantum Minesweeper. So here I've written the code for a quantum circuit with 6 cycles, and we can see what this looks like. So you can see on the quantum circuit here that I've turned the control knots into controlled knots. This means that the bomb is in a superposition of being there and not being there. Then at the end of the circuit, I measure the control qubit so that I can find out whether the bomb was there or not there by collapsing the superposition. I can then compare this to my prediction of whether or not the bomb was there based on the outcome of the qubit in the bomb tester. So my game uses a quantum bomb tester on a quantum bomb. So now I'll have a go at playing my game of quantum Minesweeper. So my qubit has predicted that there is no bomb. I'm going to trust the qubit and type a 0, and I was right. So I got a point added to my score. If I play again and trust the qubit again, I got another point. So I can keep playing and keep trusting the qubit. And this time I predicted wrong, so it was one of the cases where the qubit was wrong, there's no bomb, so my score was 2. Now, my highest score on this game with 6 bean splitters is 8. So that's how you play Quantum Minesweeper on a simulator. Now we can see why this quantum circuit works by running the circuit lots of times and seeing what the histogram looks like. So you can see here that the 2 most likely outcomes are the ones where we've either predicted correctly that the bomb is not there, or predicted correctly that the bomb is there without the bomb ever having exploded. Now, what happens if we try and use the quantum bomb tester on real quantum hardware? Well, then we face a dilemma. The more gates we add to our bomb tester, the more noise we add, which disrupts the quantum circuit. You can find out more about mitigating noise on quantum hardware in this episode of Coding with Qiskit. So I'm going to leave you with a challenge. What is the best bomb tester that you can make on real IBM quantum hardware? Let us know how you do in the comments. All the code is linked in a Jupyter notebook below. Thanks for watching and have fun testing your own quantum bombs. See you next time.